Good morning, students. Today, let us discuss one interesting concept called motional EMF, motional electromotive force. Already we studied about induced EMF. Induced EMF will be generating due to the variation of magnetic flux linked with the coil, due to the relative motion between the coil and the magnet, etc., etc. There are different conditions for the generation of induced EMF. Now, this concept is little bit different from induced EMF. Here, let me consider a uniform magnetic field. In this uniform magnetic field of strength B, let me have a U-shaped metal frame. On this metal frame, let me consider a rod. Let L is the length of the rod, which is capable to move with a constant velocity on the rails of the U-shaped frame. As the rod is moving here, what will happen? Each and every atom consists of some unpaired electrons. So those electrons are also moving along with the rod. Those positive ions at room temperature will also move along with the rod. Now, here, whenever rod is moving with velocity v, each and every charged particle of the rod, either electron or positive ion, which are the charge carriers available in the rod, they will also move along with the rod. We know that Fleming left hand rule. This rule will provide us the direction of force due to magnetic field. So that is I into L bar cross B bar. This force direction is given by Fleming left hand rule. As per Fleming left hand rule, if we stretch the three fingers of left hand which are perpendicular to one another, the middle finger represents current, field and force. In this case, as the charged particle, suppose if I consider a positive charged particle, this positive charged particle is moving along with the rod with velocity v in this direction. So this is the direction of conventional current. The direction of motion of positive charge is considered as direction of current. Field is into the paper. So it experiences a force in which direction? Upward direction. So all the positive charges will be deposited at the upper end of the rod. At the same time, the negative charges will be deposited at the lower end of the rod. Hence, upper end of rod get positive potential, lower end of the rod will get negative potential. There exists a potential difference between the two ends of the rod. This potential difference is developed due to the motion of the rod. So the EMF or the potential difference developed between the ends of the rod because of the motion of the rod, hence that EMF is called motional EMF. As the positive potential is developed here and negative potential is developed here, it is acting like a cell. Suppose in case of a cell, we have a positive terminal and negative terminal. So this positive terminal and negative terminal, and this is the representation of a cell. Exactly, this rod is acting like a cell. And as it is sliding over a rail of conducting wire, current will pass from positive terminal to negative terminal like this. Within the rod, the current has to move from negative terminal to positive terminal to get it continued in the circuit. Even in case of cell connected to a resistor, the current always moves from positive terminal to negative terminal outside the circuit outside the cell, inside the circuit, and inside the cell the current moves from negative terminal to positive terminal. Here the current which is moving from negative terminal to positive terminal is called motional current or induced current. The direction of this induced current can be given by a law called Fleming's right hand rule. Already we studied about Fleming left hand rule. Fleming left hand rule is applicable in electromagnetism chapter. Electromagnetism chapter. This Fleming right hand rule is applicable in electromagnetic induction chapter. What is Fleming right hand rule? Let us see. Again, the same is the case with left hand rule. We have to stretch the three fingers of right hand. So if we stretch the three fingers of right hand, this thumb is representing force, this index finger is representing field, and the middle finger is representing current. Current, field, force. Now here force means the direction in which the rod is moving. Because of the application of force only, the rod is able to move in this direction. Hence this is the direction of force. This is the direction of field. The current is moving upwards. The current is moving from negative terminal to positive terminal. So the direction of induced current. The direction of induced current. Direction of induced current. Is given by Fleming right hand rule. The direction of induced current is given by Fleming's right hand rule. Here the direction of induced current is nothing but the direction in which the drift velocity is developed. Electrons are drifting from negative terminal to positive terminal. So the direction of drift velocity is given by Fleming's right hand rule, which is used in the chapter of electromagnetic induction. Once again you say, what is motional EMF? Whenever a metal rod is moving with certain velocity in a magnetic field, then there exists some positive and negative potentials over the ends of the rod, and this rod is acting like a cell, and the EMF of the terminals of the rod is considered as motional EMF. And the direction of the induced current is given by Fleming's right hand rule. So always we use Fleming right hand rule in case of electromagnetic induction to identify the direction of induced current. Now I would like to give an expression, mathematical expression, for the developed EMF over here, or motional EMF developed over here. In order to derive expression for this, first let me take this distance as x at any particular instant of time t. At a particular time t, the rod is located at this position. It is at a distance x from this origin. Now what is the flux linked with this closed loop? Flux linked with closed loop, that is magnetic flux. Flux is given by B bar dot A bar, that is nothing but BA cos t. Here A means area of the closed loop. Here length is nothing but length of the rod, breadth is nothing but x. L into x will give the area. Area is given by Lx. Now theta. Theta is the angle between B bar and A bar. Theta is the angle between A bar and B bar. A bar is nothing but area vector normal to the plane of the area. So normal to the plane of the area is like this. Magnetic field is into the paper. What is the angle between them? The angle is 180 degrees. So if I substitute them here, the magnetic flux is given by B into area is Lx cos 180 degrees. Cos 180 is minus 1. So minus BLx is the magnetic flux linked with the coil. Now induced EMF is given by minus N into d phi b by dt. This is the general formula. Here number of turns is 1, so EMF is given by minus d by dt of minus BLx. Minus into minus, it becomes plus. So induced EMF is given by B, strength of the magnetic field fixed, L length of the rod is fixed, dx by dt. E B L dx by dt is nothing but rate of variation in this distance, nothing but velocity. Dx by dt is velocity. So the EMF, motional EMF, is given by the formula BVL, strength of the magnetic field into length of the rod into velocity with which it is moving inside the magnetic field. But here magnetic field is a vector, length of the rod in a particular direction is considered as a vector, velocity of the rod is also considered as vector. So there is three elements are considered as vectors. That's why we represent the EMF as box product, L bar dot V bar cross B bar. So this is the general formula for finding motional EMF, or box product of E is box product of BVL. So if you expand the box product, you will get the direction of motional EMF. So this is the very, very important idea. And here we introduced a new law, Fleming's right hand rule, for identification of direction of induced current. Once again, I am going to repeat the concept of motional EMF. We have a rod of length L. This rod is sliding over a U-shaped metal frame. It is sliding with a constant velocity V. As long as it is sliding, the flux linked with this closed loop is going to increase. First, at a particular instant of time, the flux linked with the closed loop is given by phi is equal to BA bar, that is BA cos theta. Angle between B and A is 180 degrees. Hence, flux is given by B into area of the loop is length into distance, x, Lx cos 180 minus BLx. By substituting it in Faraday law, you will get expression for motional EMF as BVL. And strictly speaking, as it is a scalar quantity, we should have a scalar product here. Upon taking cross product, again you will get a vector. This is a dot product. So the dot product always leads to a scalar value. Hence, we define motional EMF as box product of BVL. And the direction of the induced current is given by Fleming right hand rule. What is Fleming right hand rule? Whenever we stretch the three fingers of our right hand such that this is force finger, this is field finger, this is current finger. Force will give the direction of velocity of the rod. Field is into the paper, so current is upwards. Always the current moves from negative terminal to positive terminal, since the moving rod inside the magnetic field is acting like a cell. Hence, the direction of induced current inside the rod is from negative to positive. It is like drift velocity of electrons due to the presence of electric field. I hope everybody understood this. And in order to understand the direction of induced current, we have one more rule. That rule is right hand palm rule. That also we will discuss now. Now let us discuss one more interesting concept. In the earlier concept, the considered rod of length L, it is moving with the velocity V in linear motion inside a time independent uniform magnetic field. Now the same rod of length L moving with same linear velocity V, but it is in rotatory motion with angular velocity O. With O as center, this rod is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. Due to the rotation of the rod also, some motional EMF gets developed here. The aim of this concept is to find the motional EMF developed across the two ends of the rod due to its rotatory motion. As the rod is rotating with angular velocity omega here, each and every particle of the rod is having some linear velocity v like this. Suppose if you consider Fleming left hand rule, the thumb is representing the force direction. Force is nothing but the direction of velocity. Magnetic field is into the paper, so current should go in this way. So all the positive charged particles motion is considered as conventional current direction. So conventionally, the positive charges should go and deposit it over here. Obviously, negative charges will go and deposit over here. Hence, we will get a positive potential at this end and we will get a negative potential at this end. Some EMF gets developed across the two ends of the rod of length L, and that EMF is the emotional EMF, what I would like to find now. In order to find the emotional EMF developed due to the rotation of a rod with angular velocity omega, let me consider a small element of the rod having length dx, which is located at a distance x as shown in figure. If you consider the small element, its length is dx, it is also moving with linear velocity v, and it is rotating in a circle of radius x. Due to the rotation, but its small elemental motion is considered as linear motion. Entire rod is in rotatory motion, but for time being, this small element of length dx, it is moving with velocity v in a strength, in a magnetic field of strength b. So some EMF gets developed at the two ends of the small element. The EMF developed is dE. Because of the small element, we took the value dE, bv dx. So bv dx, how did you get this? You know that E is equal to bvl. E is equal to bvl, as we discussed earlier. From this formula, the EMF developed across the ends of the small element is given by bv dx. In order to get the EMF developed due to the entire rod, we need to integrate this on both sides. While doing integration, I should remove this v, because v is a function of x. You know that v is the linear velocity, omega is the angular velocity. How the linear velocity and angular velocity are related to each other? Linear velocity is equal to radius into angular velocity. In the particular case, the element is rotating on a circle of radius x. So, x into omega will give the linear velocity of the element you considered. So, in the place of v, I should write x omega. And here b, strength of the magnetic field constant, omega is the angular velocity with which the rod is rotating. That is also constant. So, by keeping them out, integral x dx I should write. It is in the form of x power n dx, x square by 2 will be the integral result. And here x varies from, that means this element might be considered at this end, then x is 0. The same element might be considered at this end, then the distance is L, or x is L. So 0 to L are the limits. By substituting the limits, you got emotional EMF value as half b omega L square. Clearly, once again, I am stating, here is a rod of length L. It is rotating with angular velocity omega in anti-clockwise direction. Due to the rotatory motion of the rod also, some EMF gets developed. The developed EMF can be found by using this procedure. And here, the induced current or motional current, it has to go from negative terminal to positive terminal. Why? It is acting as a cell. Inside the cell, current will go from negative terminal to positive terminal. Similarly, here, motional current should go from negative to positive. Yeah, like this. If you want motional current, you should take EMF by resistance. Okay? Here, whenever some external circuit is connected, then the motional current concept will come. Otherwise, only motional EMF will be there. Okay? So, due to the rotation of rod of length L with an angular velocity omega in a magnetic field of strength B, the EMF developed is given by half B omega L square. I hope everybody followed this. Very, very important for our board examination. Now let us see one problem. The problem is like this. A wire PQ of resistance R and length L is moving with velocity V. On U-shaped rails, on U-shaped rails in a region of uniform transverse. In a uniform transverse magnetic field of strength B. Magnetic field of strength B. Resistance of the rails is negligible. Resistance of rails is negligible. Draw the equivalent circuit diagram. Draw the equivalent circuit diagram representing induced EMF by battery. Also find current in the wire. Also find current in the wire. This is the question. So here is a U-shaped rail. On this U-shaped rail, there is a rod. This rod is moving with velocity. Rod is having length L. It is moving with velocity V and it is having resistance R. This is a rail. This is the question. We need to find or we need to draw equivalent circuit diagram representing the induced EMF. Now first of all, and here is a magnetic field, magnetic transverse magnetic field of strength B. Let me take the magnetic field out of the paper. Earlier earlier question we took into the paper, anything you can take. So this dotted structure is representing uniform magnetic field out of the paper, B out of the paper. We would like to draw equivalent circuit for the given situation. Solution. If you observe clearly, as the rod is moving, it gets some EMF at the two ends. Which end will get positive potential and which end will get negative potential? Now let us see the solution. The solution is like this. Here magnetic field is out of the paper. Rod is moving like this. Rod is moving means each and every charge carrier of the rod is moving in this way. Suppose if I consider a positive charge to charge carrier, that charge carrier is moving like this. So from Fleming left hand rule, as the charge carrier is moving like this, current is like this, field is out of the paper, so it experiences force in the downward direction. Once again I am saying, if you consider a positive charge carrier inside the rod, due to the motion of the rod, the positive charge carrier is moving like this, hence current is going like this, magnetic field is out of the paper, so it expresses force in the downward direction, so it will get positive potential here, it will get negative potential here, and the EMF developed here is given by BVL, already we calculated. What is the difference between earlier problem what we discussed and now? earlier field is into the paper, therefore positive here, negative here you got. As the field is reversed, the polarity on the rod also got reversed. Conventionally, the current will go from positive potential to negative potential like this. Inside the rod, the current will go from negative potential to positive potential like this. The strength of the current is given by EMF by resistance. Here, resistance of the rails is negligibly small. Only resistance of the rod is considered. Therefore, BVL by R is the strength of the current passing through it. And the resistance of the rod is nothing but resistance of this cell. Every moving rod inside the magnetic field will act as a cell. So this resistance will act as internal resistance of the cell. So while drawing equivalent circuit, the cell is having negative potential at the top, positive potential at the bottom, and having some internal resistance R, and it is connected to an external wire whose resistance is negligibly small. And the EMF of this cell is given by BVL, and the strength of the current passing through the wire is given by BVL by R. This is the equivalent circuit as per the given question. I hope everybody understood the solution. Now let us discuss a rule called right hand palm rule. Right hand palm rule. This right hand palm rule is useful for identification of polarity of the motional EMF. Which end of the rod will get negative charge? Which end of the rod will get positive charge? Can be easily understood either with the help of Fleming left hand rule or right hand palm rule. So Fleming's right hand palm rule, let us discuss now. Whenever we stretch our right hand fingers such that remaining four fingers are in one direction, our thumb is in one direction, they are perpendicular to one another. If we stretch the hand like this, the remaining fingers should represent the direction of magnetic field. In this case, magnetic field is out of the paper. So magnetic field is like this. This thumb should represent the direction of motion of the rod or velocity of the rod. So velocity of the rod is that side. So velocity should be represented by the thumb. Remaining fingers should represent the direction of magnetic field. Then the side of the palm, you will get positive potential. Other side, you will get negative potential. This rule is called right hand palm rule. Once again, I am stating the right hand palm rule. As per right hand palm rule, if we stretch the fingers of our right hand such that the thumb is perpendicular to the remaining fingers and the remaining fingers are directed in the direction of magnetic field and thumb is directed in the direction of velocity of the rod, then the side of the palm you will get positive potential and other side of the palm you will get negative potential. This rule is called right hand palm rule, very useful for identification of polarity of a motional EMF. Polarity of motional EMF. I hope everybody understood this. Based on this, let us solve one problem. Based on this, let us solve one problem. The problem is like this. Figure shows four conducting rods. With end points marked on them, with end points marked on them. Their dimensions are also their dimensions are also mentioned in the figure. Their dimensions are also mentioned in the figure. Each rod is being moved with a velocity v. Figure. What is the EMF developed between the endpoints of each rod? Between the endpoints of each rod. The figures are like this. Everywhere magnetic field is into the paper. This is the first figure. In the first figure, this is the rod. The endpoints are named as AB. The length of the rod is L, capital L they give, and is moving down with velocity V. In the second case, similar magnetic field of strength B is available. Same rod of length L and velocity V. But velocity V is parallel to the length of the rod now. In the third case, similar magnetic field of strength B. This is the rod. The rod is moving with velocity V. This velocity is making an angle theta with the horizontal. Length of the rod is L. And here, the name of the rod is given as CD. Here, the name of the rod is given as PQ. Next. The last case. Here is a magnetic field. This magnetic field consists of a U-shaped rod like this. This rod name is LR. MS. And length again L. This L is the name of this terminal, or L dash. Okay. And it is moving, and this end, this edge also having length L, it is moving with velocity V like this. In all the four situations, we need to find the EMF developed and the polarity of that EMF. So this is the question given to us. We need to solve this. Solution is quite simple. By considering motional EMF concept as well as right hand palm rule, you only can say solution for the first figure. What is the solution? As per form right hand palm rule, magnetic field is into the paper, so remaining fingers are into the paper. Velocity of the rod is like this. Okay, palm is that side, so you will get positive potential this side, you will get negative potential this side, and the EMF developed is given by L bar dot B bar cross B bar here, L bar dot B bar cross B bar. So as V and B are perpendicular to each other, VB sine 90, sine 90 is 1, and V bar cross B bar is parallel to L bar, so cos 0 is 1. So you will get simply BVL. The polarity is, for B you will get positive potential and for A you will get negative potential. So that is the solution for this. That means B is at higher potential. Potential at B is higher. Higher in the sense positive potential is conventionally taken as higher potential. If you go to the second question, here also you will get induced EMF given by L bar dot V bar cross V bar. V bar and B bar are perpendicular to one another. So you will get VB sine 90. That is okay. But V bar cross B bar, V bar cross B bar is perpendicular to L bar. V bar cross B bar is perpendicular to L bar. Hence, cos 90 is 0. So you will get 0 in this one. Once again, I am saying V bar is like this, B bar is into the paper. V bar cross B bar, if you calculate VB sine 90, that is VB only. But V bar cross B bar will be perpendicular to the plane containing V and B. V is like this, B is like this. So perpendicular to these two means it is in the upward direction, perpendicular to the length of the rod. So angle between L bar and V bar cross B bar is 90. So while expanding dot, cos 90 is 0. So EMF developed is 0. No EMF gets developed if the rod is moving parallel to its length and perpendicular to the magnetic field. So this is the solution for the second point. Now let us see the third point. Here velocity is having two components. One is V cos theta, another one is V sin. Just now we have seen, if velocity is perpendicular to the length, then you will get some EMF. If velocity is parallel to the length, no EMF gets developed. So V sin theta will not contribute any EMF. Only V cos theta is contributing the EMF. So what is the EMF polarity? Velocity is like this, magnetic field is into the paper. So you will get P is at high potential, Q is at low potential. And the EMF developed is given by B V cos theta, because V cos theta is the velocity. Yeah. Length of the rod, you take it as capital L, no problem. Length of the rod, you can take it as capital L. Okay, even in the first case. And potential at P is higher. Potential at P is higher. So that is the solution at solution for the third question. So BVL cos theta is the answer. Potential at P is higher. Similarly, last question. If you take the velocity here, this velocity is perpendicular to this portion of the rod, that is L dash M. The same velocity is parallel to L dash R and MS. So no EMF will be developed across L dash R and MS as velocity is parallel. So the solution for fourth one, EMF developed is 0 for L dash R comma MS. And EMF developed is given by, again, BVL. BVL. And here you see, palm velocity is like this, remaining fingers are in magnetic field direction, palm is downwards, so you will get positive potential here, negative potential here. Velocity or potential at M is higher. Potential at M is higher. This is the solution for this question. This is the solution for this question. It's very, very simple. And from this question, we understood the box product loop and its usage while solving problems. And also we understood the application of right hand palm rule. Hence, this application is very, very important for learning the concept of motional EMF as well as right hand palm rule to know the polarity of induced EMF developed or motional EMF developed.